Most people look at this and see an apple. At Apeel, we see a database filled with millions of years of information and nature's molecular building blocks, which make a lemon more lasting than a strawberry. And we see sustainable ways to use seeds and skins from plants, extracting the molecules that make up their protective shield, applying this extra peel to other fruits and vegetables, giving them added protection that increases their lifespan by up to 3 times without using harmful chemicals. And when all that's done, we still don't see an apple. We see you getting to eat more of the food you buy. We see a global food system that helps everyone thrive. We see less food waste and greater abundance for all, creating a healthier planet. It matters how you see the world, especially if you want to feed it. At Apeel, we see ways to use the power of nature to make a difference in the world every day. What you see is what you get.
It matters how you see the world, especially if you want to feed it. As we created the animation you just watched, that was one line we played with and adjusted to get right. The original script was, "It matters how you see the world, especially if you want to change it." But at Apeel, we're focused not so much on changing the world as living better within it. Focused on what nature can show us about how to better take care of people through abundance, and the planet too, through more sustainable practices. For us, the shelf life extension possibilities that we're known for are just the beginning. Today, we can measure with ease the days we add to the life of produce we treat. Maybe you've seen our time lapses at trade shows or online. They tell a story through contrast and have been the best marketing we could buy for our first 6 years. But we want to go further with our knowledge, and together with the industry, we want to ask of ourselves, can we measure not just days, but also taste, aroma, nutrition? Can we measure quality itself? And if we could, just imagine being able to pinpoint moments of ripeness for consumers and the properties they seek in ways that have never before been possible. My name is James Rogers. I'm the CEO of Apeel, and I'm coming to you from the Fruit Quality Lab at our headquarters, where even through this crisis, we have continued gathering data and insights for our customers. It may sound simple, but that very act of scientific observation and data gathering is at the heart of Apeel's practice. It's the promise we're able to make to our customers and to consumers. In many ways, food quality has never been more important. As America and the world confront a food supply chain severely impacted by the COVID crisis, we're focused on providing resilience and quality food that can do good. For us, this is a story not about any specific characteristic associated with Apeel, like shelf life extension, but the very idea of quality that endures. Quality. It's an age-old pursuit, no doubt a frequent promise made by sellers since humankind first started trading goods. Everyone wants that assurance. Sam Walton once said, "Quality is to give customers what they want." Yes, but on the path from farm to table, how do we as an industry measure that quality? Is it size, color, shape? Could we go past cosmetic measurements to perceive things more deeply? And then, seeing things with greater depth, what could we do with that knowledge to go further with produce? The fact is, everybody is promising quality to customers, yet the benchmarks for delivering it remain fluid. It's qualitative from one point in the supply chain to the next. So in this age of technology, why are we still going with our gut? Over hundreds of years of innovation, the industry has created a model for working with nature that we can look to. That work, creating new varieties of fruits and vegetables with tailored attributes from taste to transportability, points the way to further innovation and is inspiration for our work at Apeel. We see an opportunity to use innovative methodology and robust research to create an understanding of quality that is more tangible and quantifiable than ever before. In the same way that we saw the building blocks of Apeel, we can look to nature using scientific observation and non-invasive approaches to establish new ways of quantifying quality. Today, I want to share with you the multiple dimensions we consider when we're talking about quality. I'll talk about some novel methodologies for quantifying it across produce categories and what's still on the horizon to create quality measurement that is more comprehensive for all. As we work to build the future of food supply chain that is resilient and abundant, sustainable and delicious, we want to be able to work together as partners in the industry to create not only greater resilience, but also quality that can be quantified. In doing that, we can build towards sustainable abundance and a stronger food system. So what is quality? We know that quality degrades as produce progresses from grower to grocery cart and contributes to $1 trillion in lost food value every year. But what is quality for the produce industry? Is it the reddest tomato, regardless of the taste, or the non-bruising apple that may not have that snap? Or is it quite simply the best tasting, most nutritious piece of produce you can find? Today, the definition is often subjective based on where you sit. Working across the supply chain with our partners, from growers to packers to retailers, it became clear that today quality means different things to different stakeholders. For packers, there's a need to evaluate external qualities like size and grade in order to reduce rejections and deliver uniformity. For retailers, it's about maintaining weight and color and sometimes that particular shine. But we all know at the end of the day, success lies in the hands of how consumers assess our quality. As customers have a range of measurements from taste and texture to value and convenience, not to mention color preference, smell tests, and appearance judgments. Despite the many variables that make up quality, to reach the broadest audience, we've ended up rewarding cosmetic elements. As a result, today we have a food system that prioritizes basic attributes to deliver uniform, larger size produce year-round. Those attributes are familiar to most of us, but worth restating as a starting point. Color, it's the easiest way to grade and sort in an automated way. Firmness, a proxy for ripeness, it's nevertheless measured through imprecise tests like bending cucumbers or squeezing avocados. And in certain settings, we see the use of tests like penetrometers that are destructive and can lead to waste. Then there's weight. We use it to understand the value and water content. And finally, taste. While this is often the most important influencer for consumers, measuring taste can be limited and very subjective. You can't just Brix acid everything and get the full picture of taste. At Apeel, we started by thinking of quality from a shelf life perspective. How long can a piece of produce maintain all of these aforementioned qualities, and could we extend that window? The answer has been a resounding yes, as we've been able to maintain quality over time, an average of 2x shelf life extension, a 50% reduction of waste for our partners, and we're on track to save 20 million pieces of produce from being wasted this year alone. But along the way, our scientific methods have allowed us to capture a unique database that reflects more varied dimensions of quality. As we see it, quality can be defined beyond the current cosmetic standards using advanced measurement tools rather than intuition. So what would a more comprehensive vision of quality look like? Let's start by expanding the various dimensions that might influence anybody's perception of quality and ultimately purchase decisions. We can consider a wider range of external attributes. Size, color, uniformity, intensity, shape, lack of blemishes, decay or mold, weight or water content, firmness. Then there are the internal attributes. Taste, sweet, sour, bitter, salty, umami, aroma, texture. And lastly, what we might call secondary aspects. Packaging, sustainability, shelf life, value, country of origin, differentiated or proprietary genetics. Nutrition. To better map the spectrum of possibilities, we're using methodologies drawn from academia and the sciences, refining and improving them for commercial purposes. It allows us to more effectively visualize and quantify varied dimensions of quality. It's work we're doing across different categories, and it draws from Apeel's underlying foundation in scientific research. We started by observing nature, studying the fundamentals of how quality degrades in fresh produce. In a nutshell, or within Apeel in this case, moisture, as in water, goes out, and air, as in oxygen, goes in. The result is maturation and eventually spoilage. In developing our plant-derived extra peel, we aim to slow water loss and oxidation to create an ideal microclimate inside each piece of fruit. We developed commercial tests of our efficacy in doing both. First, water loss. We measure mass loss to understand the rate at which water leaves a piece of produce, or desiccation. It's what leads to shriveling, dry pulp, and quality loss. Also, respiration. Just like us, produce needs to breathe, taking in oxygen and releasing CO2. We created respiration chambers that measure the rate of CO2 leaving produce. The higher the rate, the faster the ripening. At first, they featured simple CO2 sensors, then we added lights for imaging, and now we're automating the entire process. But this is not just a lab process. At every installation we have from Yakima, Washington to Rotterdam, the Netherlands, we perform holdback research using these key tests. Today and every day, these tests allow us to measure key indices of quality using commercially what had generally been relegated to academia. Building data with every holdback rack, after 2 years of commercialization, we're gleaning unique data and insights for the produce industry and our partners to use. Data around quality. But we weren't satisfied with these two measurements. We also challenged ourselves to find consistent ways to measure external quality without damaging the produce. For firmness, using a durometer instead of a penetrometer, we developed a non-destructive way to measure fruit firmness over time. It's much more exact than squeezing by hand, and much less destructive than punching through produce. If you've seen our time-lapse videos, you can understand the power of capturing high-quality images. We keep meticulous records of external and internal appearance, and use visual maps to score the overall quality and the incidence and severity of disorders on each piece of produce. Doing this work, we can gain a long view of produce behavior, with highly specific category and subcategory data insights around quality that reflect both external and internal dynamics. For us, sustainability is also a key metric of quality. While it's a more intangible measurement, an understanding of the environmental impacts of taking a piece of produce from the farm to fork is critical in creating a more resilient food system and is of growing importance to consumers. We use life cycle assessment to quantify the greenhouse gas emissions, water footprint, energy consumption, and a number of environmental impacts across the supply chain to ultimately calculate and communicate the impact of Apeel. Apeel's LCA metrics are generated using in-house expertise and are verified by a third party according to internationally recognized standards. Looking to nature for answers, we have a continual sense of both awe and possibility. And as we look to the future, we have been developing techniques for understanding nature's bounty that would allow us to quantify internal and more intangible attributes. Imagine being able to differentiate produce on store shelves using unique flavors or even nutritional value. We're honing tools for quality and shelf life prediction by taking our growing database of measurements to build a prediction engine using AI. It may sound like a tall order, but the reams of data we've generated through our practices from Yakima and Rotterdam means much of the groundwork has already been laid for this possible future. And our powers of observation are becoming more sophisticated, layered with data as we move forward. We're developing quality measurements determined by specialized imaging that can see more than what we can see with our naked eyes, deeper into surface phenomena. Layering images with data sets, we're working to understand and predict not just quality problems, but quality attributes like taste and smell, even nutrition. Adding to our original tag team of tests, borrowed from academia and put to use in the commercial setting, we're testing the use of infrared spectroscopy to predict and understand internal quality, firmness, and shelf life, as well as even taste. For example, we're using this tool to understand how hundreds of compounds contribute to aroma and flavor profiles. In a world where so much produce is discarded because it doesn't deliver on basic quality attributes, we are wasting a precious resource to feed the future and realize the full potential of food we grow. We can work with what nature provides to understand quality traits ranging from shelf life to flavor. We can help find new quality selling points that help sell the whole tree, be it sweet but ugly, small but vitamin packed. This strategy would not only be more sustainable, but also help reprioritize the characteristics that consumers find most important, including taste, shelf life, and nutrition. To explore these frontiers of produce quality, we hope to expand partnership with forward-looking players across the supply chain. In the end, we'll be building a stronger food system powered by resilient technologies and new insights about quality. So I hope you'll learn more about Apeel and gain a sense of possibility in partnering with us. I believe that together, we can build enduring quality that helps create a more abundant and sustainable food system.